Right, I'm going to start back on Roald Dahl again. In my Operation Blackjack series, I covered Roald Dahl, found out quite a few things, especially about his magic finger rituals, his magic finger book. Guaranteed Freemason, of course, but there's more, there's always more with this guy, and it always gets darker and deeper. Right. Now, I was looking through German Jewish surnames again, and of course Dahl comes up, and Dahlberg, and Dahlem, Dahlebusch, Dahlheimer, and Blumen Dahl, etc., etc. Dahl, there it is, right? Of German Jewish origin. Okay, this is the German Jewish list of surnames. Now, so already Roald Dahl. Of Jewish origin, a Freemason, as are all and were all celebrated authors. Okay, particularly in children's books, but it gets very, very dark. Now, here is the immediate link with paedophilia, right? And Tessa Dahl, right? His wife. Now, I'll play this again.
Well, Gary, your fans cut across all age groups and include Patricia Neal and the late Roald Dahl. You were introduced to them by their daughter, and she is here, Tessa Dahl.
Tessa.
Apologies, that's his Roald Dahl's not wife, daughter.
Tessa, were you impressed from the very beginning?
Oh, always greatly impressed. Oh. Gary actually came to live in my house when he was between jobs. And,
yeah, but I was absolutely broke.
My sister Lucy turned it into quite a successful venture because she used to pack the train full of her adolescent school friends in school uniform and they'd sky to school and she'd bring them up to the house and charge them £5 a head to come and gaze at glitter. And my sister Lucy turned it into quite a successful venture because she used to pack the train full of her adolescent school friends in school uniform and they'd sky to school and she'd bring them up to the house and charge them £5 a head to come and gaze at glitter.
Right, now, so you've got this Roald Dahl being linked to this very renowned Freemason pedo, right? Then you've now got to start looking at Roald Dahl's books in a slightly different way, a much darker Freemason way. We know Freemasonry is, well, it's a gay mafia, it's bisexual, and they love their paedophilia. They love it. I've shown you that Milk magazine and the Vogue magazine, right? Now let's go into it a bit more. Right, what else did he do? Right, he did a book called Mr. Magnolia. Now, there's been a film, Magnolia, with Tom Cruise. So, Magnolia is big time, something about it big time with Freemasonry. And as you see, again, it's always a man with a lot of little children in Roald Dahl's books, like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. You gotta start thinking of it differently now. I'm telling you. Here's Magnolia Lodge number 166, Brooklyn, New York. Right? So there's Magnolia Lodges all over the place, just like Aurora Lodges, right? Like that hoax. So, all right, there we go. He also did SEO Trot, and it was starring Mrs. Silver. Of course, that's another Jewish surname. You know, he could have picked any name, but no, Mrs. Silver, because he's Jewish, right? Another link. Now, hold on a second. Now, the media does a bit of spin and says that he slated Jewish people. Well, he was Jewish, all right? What he's saying here, There is a trait in the Jewish character that does provoke animosity. Maybe it's a kind of lack of generosity towards non-Jews. Well, goyim. I mean that there is always a reason why anti-anything crops up anywhere. Even a stinker like Hitler didn't just pick on them for no reason. Now, that's a perfectly reasonable comment by him there. I will say that. It's cause and effect. Of course, and they never look at that. The Zionists never look to the fact that they were the cause in the first place. They always are. I mean, look what they're doing. Come on, look what they're doing. Right, so let's get back onto it. So he was Jewish. Here's your magic finger. This is the magic finger rituals of Freemasonry. Codex Magica, right? Magic finger, Roald Dahl, all Freemasonry rituals. Here's his granddaughter, Sophie Dahl. She must have had a very strange upbringing on Red Communist magazine, of course, the colours of Bolshevik communism, but also red, really meaning the red manes, you know, the Jewish people actually being mostly red manes. Red hair, Eddie Redmayne's, Robert Redford, Gene Rosen, etc., etc. So now I'm going to cut this one short, but here you have a look at a top-hatted Mason here, Roald Dahl, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, another Mason with a bunch of children in a chocolate factory. It's his chocolate factory. James and the Giant Peach, what do you think that is? Come on, Peach. Huh? Think about it. The witches, well, that's self-explanatory. The Fantastic Mr. 666. Add an A to that one. Roald Dahl Boy. Oh, it's... Oh, I haven't even gone through the rest of these yet. I'm going to have to go into this far more deeply because it's all Freemasonry. Look at the pyramids here going solo. Look, it's just like a bunch of Orion pyramids, Egyptian Freemason pyramids on this one. Let's have a look. Right. Dirty beasts. Dirty beasts. Ooh, look at that. The raven, the most satanic symbol of all. Ghost stories, Roald Dahl. The umbrella, Freemason umbrella. The Vicar of Nibbleswick. Dodgy, dodgy. Sorry about this, I'm just going through this for the first time. Just having a little look immediately at what's here. You tell me what you see here as well. Okay. All right. So, yeah, there's something a little bit massively dodgy about this Jewish Freemason.